Hello and welcome to another crochet tutorial. I'm Sarah at Totally Stitchcraft and today I'll be showing you how to make the spiral snake granny square. This one can be made with quite a few different colors, but for this tutorial I'll only be using two. I'll be using a dark green and a light green color. These are a size 4 weight yarn and I'm using a 5mm crochet hook. I'll also be using scissors and a tapestry needle later on. You can do this with any gauge of yarn, any size hook that goes along with your yarn, and any amount of colors that you want to make it with. Well, technically we'll need black for the eyes, but you need such a small amount that I didn't really count it in the colors. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to be doing my base with this dark green yarn. And to start off, we need to make a ring. We can either do so with a chain 4 and slip stitch to your first chain to make a ring, or you can make a magic ring. So either method works. And once I have that ring, I'm going to chain 2, which I will not count as a stitch. Inside this ring, we're going to place 8 half double crochet stitches. To half double crochet, I will yarn over my hook, place my hook through the ring, and pull up a loop. I've got 3 loops on my hook. I will yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And I will do that 8 times. When I've got 8 half double crochets inside my loop, I will find my tail and pull it tight. And then I'm going to slip stitch to the first stitch in my round. I'm ignoring that chain 2 that we did, and I'm finding that first stitch here and doing my slip stitch, and then I will chain 1. Now I've got 8 stitches in my round 1, and we're moving on to round 2. In round 2, we are going to place an increase half double crochet into every stitch in this round, so we'll have 16 half double crochets at the end. But something special about this round is that we're going to be working in the back loop only. Now, when I look at my stitch here, I can see that there is this V that makes up my stitch, and I'm only going to be placing my stitches in the back loop, which is a loop facing away from me. So inside the back loop of every stitch, I will place 2 half double crochets in this round. 1 and 2. Again, just grabbing that back loop, because when we come back around and we put our snake on the front of our granny square, we're going to be working in the front loops. So make sure that you're catching just that back loop, or you're going to have a really hard time making the little snake that we're going to put on here. All right, I've got 16 stitches in my round, and I'm going to slip stitch to the first stitch in the round. Now when I do my slip stitch, I do go through both loops of the stitch, and then I will chain 1. And so now we're moving on to round 3, and in round 3 we're going to place 1 half double crochet and then 1 half double crochet increase, and then 1 half double crochet, 1 increase all the way around. So the way that looks is that we're going to put in 1 half double crochet. And the next stitch we'll place 2, so that's our increase, and then we'll place 1 in the next and 2 in the next, and we'll just repeat that 1 2 1 2 all the way around. And in this round with the increases, you will have 24 stitches. So I will meet you back when we've got 24 stitches in this round. I've got 24 stitches at the end of round 3, and I'm going to slip stitch to my first stitch and chain 1. Now in the next round, we're also going to be doing an increase, but we'll do 1 half double crochet, 1 half double crochet, then our increase. So it's 2 singles and then an increase. And we're going to repeat that all the way around. And again, we're working in the back loop only. We're doing that for all of the circular parts of this granny square. So I had a single, and a double, and we'll just repeat that. At the end of this round, you will have 32 half double crochet stitches. And again, that pattern is single, single, increase. So we'll do 1 half double crochet, one half double crochet, and then two half double crochet. I've got 32 stitches in this round, and I'm going to slip stitch to my first stitch and chain one. And in this next round, I'm going to be placing three half double crochets all in their own stitches and then my increase. So I've got one, two, three half double crochets, and then I'm going to place my half double crochet increase in the next stitch, one and two. So we'll do that for the entire round. One, two, three, all in their own stitch, and then we'll get our increase. So we place two in the same stitch, and we'll continue this all the way around, and we will have 40 stitches at the end. All right, we just finished round five with 40 stitches. We will slip stitch, chain one, and now we're gonna be working our last circular round. And at the end of this round, we'll have 48 half double crochet stitches. In order to do this one, we will half double crochet four times, all in their own stitch, one, two, three, and four, and then we'll place our increase in the fifth, and we'll repeat that. So one, two, three, and four, and then we'll place our increase in the fifth. And so repeat that till the end. You'll have 48 stitches, and we will slip stitch and then square off our circle. We've got 48 stitches in the end of this round. I will slip stitch to my first stitch and chain three. Now we're going to be squaring off our circle. And we've got 48 stitches around. Four of those stitches are gonna be corner stitches, which means we've got 48 minus four, which is 44 stitches that get to be our sides. And squares have four sides. So divide that by four, we get 11, which means there will be 11 stitches on each side, and the corners, there will be one stitch each corner. In my corners, I'm going to be placing a group of stitches, but along the sides, I'm gonna be placing one stitch into each stitch. But they're gonna be different heights. We've started with this chain three, which is going to count as our triple crochet. And then in the same space, I'm gonna place two double crochet stitches, one and two. And then, so that's half of our first corner. When we finish this round, we'll come back and finish that corner. And now I need a grouping of 11 stitches, and they're going to vary in height. So we're gonna start with tall stitches, have small ones in the middle, and then tall ones again at the end. So I'm gonna place a double crochet in the next stitch and a double crochet in the next stitch. Then I'm gonna place a half double crochet and a half double crochet, each in their own stitch. So that gave us four stitches. Now we're gonna place a single crochet, and a single crochet. So that's two doubles, two half doubles, and three singles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now we're gonna place a half double crochet, a half double crochet, a double crochet, and a double crochet. And so that gives us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 stitches. And that is gonna be how we're gonna do every single side. Now that I'm in the corner space, I'm going to place two double crochet stitches into the same stitch, and then a triple crochet stitch. Now I'm gonna yarn over two times, so I've got three loops on the hook. I'm gonna stick my hook through the same stitch I've been working in and pull up a loop. I've got four loops on my hook. I'll pull through the first two, pull through the second two, and pull through the last two. And that's a triple crochet. Now I'm gonna place two more double crochets into the corner stitch, and I've got my first official corner. Now I'm going to do that side grouping again. So that was double crochet, then we've got half double, three singles, one, two, three, two more half doubles, and we'll finish out with two doubles. Now I'm going to do another corner. So I've got two double crochets, a triple, and two more double crochets into that corner. And then I've got another side. So I'm going to do another side and another corner, and then I'm going to come back and I'll show you how to finish out this one. I just finished my single crochets on this side, so I'll place my two half double crochets and two double crochets to finish off that side. And when we come back to our first corner, we still need to finish off this corner. And I need to place two double crochets into this stitch here to finish that off. And then I will slip stitch to the top of my chain three. And then I will chain three one more time. So we're gonna do one more round to really square off our granny square. And so that starts with a chain three and then two double crochets into that same stitch. And then we'll be placing double crochets into every stitch along the side. We've got 15 double crochets along each side, and then we'll get to the corners. Okay, so I'll place a double crochet in the first stitch and a double crochet in the next and one in the next. And if you get how this pattern's going, you're just gonna place a double crochet into every stitch along the side until we get to that place where we did our triple crochet. And that's the place where we're gonna repeat that corner grouping. And we're gonna do that for every side and every corner of this round. They're all gonna be the same. All right, I've made it back to my triple crochet here, my stitch. And I can tell because I've got two double crochets on either side of it. And so in the top of this stitch, I'm gonna place my two double crochets, my triple crochet, and my two more double crochets. And I'm going to repeat that along every single side and every single corner. So I will meet you back at the place where we began, where we'll finish off our first corner, join, and cut our yarn. I just finished the double crochets along the fourth side of my granny square here, and I need to place those two more double crochets in the same stitch as where I started my corner, and then slip stitch to join. I will chain one and cut my yarn, and then pull that through and pull that tight. So this is what our granny square looks like now. And then we will weave in our ends because we like to weave in our ends. And then we can work on the little sneaky. Now that we've got the base of our granny square finished, we can start on our little snake. And so we're gonna find where we have slip stitched along, and it should be fairly visible to see where your stitches are different. And then we're going to find our outer row here and the stitch right to the left of where we slip stitched. And we're gonna be beginning in that stitch right there. And so I will put a slip stitch on my hook to begin. And I will find that stitch where we began our work. And I'm going to pull my yarn through and make a single crochet. And then I'm going to pull up the loop of the next space and single crochet. And so I'm gonna be working single crochets in the front loop of every stitch in this round until we get back to the beginning. And so it should be fairly easy to find where these front stitches are, because they're the ones that we didn't stitch through. So we'll do that for every stitch, and you'll get this sort of raised stitching, which I think looks really cool. And you kind of just slide your hook underneath there and pull up your loop and do your single crochet. And now in the back, I'm actually holding my finger where my stitch is so I can guide my hook easier. And that's how I'm able to do this fairly quickly. It's because I'm actually bouncing the hook off of my finger in the back where I'm holding it. So I'll finish these stitches and then I'll show you what we do when we reach the beginning. All right, I finished all the stitches here and I can see the place where I originally slip stitched in my background color, but instead of working into this round, I'm going to go to the one before this and I'm going to put a single crochet through that first front loop. And I'm gonna single crochet into every front loop in this round, just like we did before. And so that's actually the pattern that we're gonna use this whole time, is we're going to go all the way around and every single front loop stitch. And then when we get to the beginning, we'll just go down a row. And that's what's gonna create our spiral. And we'll do that all the way into the very center of our granny square. You can skip ahead, but I'll show you every row where we go down. All right, now I'm gonna work my third round here. Again, pulling up that front loop stitch of the row before this one and working in every single space again and again and again and again. All right, I'm back at the beginning again. And so going into the row below this one, going to single crochet into every front loop. I hope you understand the pattern by now. Just single crocheting our way through here. All right, and again into our last round here, we will single crochet into every front loop. It gets a little harder with this last loop. All right, I think we got them all. I'm going to pull up a big loop, cut my yarn, and pull my yarn through. And then I'll actually thread my needle here. And I'm going to be threading this yarn back through to the back of my granny square, which will pull that tail in tight. And then we can thread it through a couple loops down here to secure our end. All right, and once we've got that secure, we can cut off our tail and take a look at our granny square. With this tail here, we are also going to send this to the back and weave it into our square here. Okay, now we've got to make the little head of our snake, and to do that, we will start with a slip stitch on our hook, and then we will chain four, and then we will work a half double crochet into the second loop from our hook. And then a double crochet in the next. And then a half double crochet in the last. And then chain one and cut our yarn. So that's going to be our little snake's head. And it's going to go on right here, but we need to put on some little eyes. So I'm actually just going to grab some dark green scrap yarn because I don't want to go get up and get black yarn. And we really don't need a lot for the eyes. We will just be placing, well, stitching through here to make some little eyes. And they're just going to be little slits like this. And again, I'll put one on this side. Cute. And I'm just going to tie that in the back. And that's going to be our little snake's eyes. Super easy. Nothing complicated. And since nobody's going to see this part, I am actually just going to cut this dark yarn. Okay. Now we've got our little snake head, and we're going to go ahead and sew that onto our square. So I will thread my needle and just tack this little guy down. Grab my other yarn. Right, and then I'll just need to tie this together and weave in my ends, and then I'll show you our finished square. And that completes our spiral snake granny square. Now you can do this with so many different colors in, it just makes it really fun. So this back is what it looks like, and then there's the front. If you want to use this tutorial to make your own square, I would love to see your work. You can tag me on Instagram using @totally_stitchcraft and share your work with me. Otherwise, I hope you have a day filled with a lot of yarn and a lot of love, and happy crocheting. Bye!